Good afternoon, and welcome once again to the Advent Music Series here at First Baptist Church of San Antonio. I'm Aaron Hufty, the Associate Pastor of Worship and Music here, and I've just got to tell you thank you for making this such a wonderful series, for being a part of this for these 16 concerts that we've had. I hope they brought you some joy, some peace, and some hope during this season. I'm so thankful to all of our artists that have been able to come and contribute, some of our local folks and some of the professional musicians from the region. We are so thankful to be able to support them and just share in their gifting. How's your heart, everyone? How are you doing as you prepare these last couple days before Christmas begins? I know there's a lot of anxiety out there, particularly with all the news that we're hearing. There's just so much to be anxious about, and yet, as believers, our hope is not founded on what the news tells us tonight. Our hope is ever and only in Jesus. And as we end this Advent season and enter the Christmas season, it's the idea that we have promise fulfilled, that God said that He would send a Savior, and He did. And we also acknowledge that God said that Jesus would come again. And so that is what we long for and look forward to. So let me also encourage you, if you're not able to make a church service tomorrow night for Christmas Eve, maybe you feel uncomfortable about getting out, our 5:30 Christmas Eve service will be live streamed. We want to come into your home and help you to celebrate this truly joyous season together in a way that is safe and comfortable and yet filled with hope. As always, our Sunday morning services are broadcast on KSAT 12 and also live streamed. We would love to be your church family. So right now, would you consider sharing this video so that others may be able to join in and participate with us? It's not lost on me that 9 months ago, Qizhen came and sat in this very room at the foot of the cross, and she played for our Lent music series. And at that time, we had no idea what the next 3/4 of a year would look like and feel like, with so much fear and anxiety, so much to be worried about. And as she sat and played, it was a moment of heavenly respite. And I cannot tell you the joy that I have today to welcome Qizhen back so that she can again help us to center ourselves in the midst of a season that is sometimes pretty frantic, in a world that is chaotic. We're also very grateful to Dr. Seth for being our accompanist du jour again. And so he is so grateful to collaborate with such these wonderful musicians. And so we're always thankful for Dr. Seth. So as we begin, every day I have read a poem. And so in lieu of a poem today, I'd like to read to you the traditional bidding prayer for the Lessons and Carols service. You may not be able to get to a Lessons and Carols service this year, but I hope this prayer gives you hope. Beloved in Christ, at this Christmas tide, let it be our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, for unity and brotherhood within the church he came to build, and especially here in San Antonio. And because this would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor, the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all those who know not Jesus or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are one forevermore. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven. Amen.